So, as you can see, we're back on the way towards our farm. We're loaded up with a lot of flour. You might also notice that we're now late in February. What we did was we sort of skipped through winter. There wasn't a great deal to do as far as work on our farm. So what we ended up doing was we took on a heap of contracts. So we pretty much take every single ploughing and cultivating contract that we could get our hands on. We used our equipment to do it. And the other thing we did was we took on a cotton planting harvest. Cotton planting contract. So we've got cotton planted back up into 19. That was the only planting contract we got a hold of. Other things we did was, like, quite a few of the fields you can see barren is what we were doing as far as cultivating, ploughing goes. And the other thing we did was we took all of our wheat and we put it all into the grain mill. Hence why we've now got 33,000 litres of wheat, of flour, sitting on the trailer. And we've still got roughly another 20-something thousand litres of wheat in the grain mill to continue producing. So what we're going to do is we'll head down to the chickens, we'll see if we've got any eggs we can load up. And we will get all of that up to the bakery in the morning. A couple of other things we did was we grabbed 2 pallets of furniture, a couple of pallets of eggs, the honey, and 3 pallets of bread, I think it was, from the bakery. And we got all that sold off over the winter. Hence why we're now back up to 158,000. Now, could make some more money and take all of this flour to the farm shop and sell that off. But what I'm thinking is bread's worth more. Let's get some light cranking. What we want to do is straighten this up just so as we have a bit more room to play with. I'm going to jump up on the trailer. There we go. That'll give us some room to put the eggs on. Now, we could... we'll see what eggs are worth. We might just take them straight to the farm shop. Although, yeah, 2.8, they can go higher than that. We've missed the cutoff. We're jumping back down in price, so we'll hold on to them. I was thinking if we could get the eggs into the bakery, although they're not going to take too much more. They'll probably take what we've got there. Ugh, it's a hard call. Nah, we'll sort of keep them for money. Change of plans, we'll save the eggs. As you can see, these were loaded on with the bobcat. They're not the smoothest of loading. Another thing we did was obviously the mowing. We got that done in the last episode. So we got that mowed up and put into into the silage pit, so that should actually be ready now as silage, but we don't need it. We don't need the pit, so it can just stay there covered until we do eventually get cows. So what we'll do, shut the lights down, turn you off, turn the beacons off. We'll go and rest overnight. Before we do that, we'll quickly have a look. No, we don't need a mower. The 44 18N, what do you belong to? So if we come into headers, that's not you, that's not you, that's not you. Am I missing something here? Oh, it's a corn header. That's why I can't find it. 4418N. That's a decent saving. And it goes to the axial flow 9250. That's a lot of money. I can't see that coming up in the specials. How much is it to lease for next year? 21 grand. Wow. Because we are not going to need a harvester, but I reckon we wait up until close to harvest. If nothing's come up in the savings before harvest, we'll get it. Bigger trailer would be nice. That is a decent sized trailer too. But we don't really need it just yet. If anything, the sort of trailer we need is probably something more along that line, because that will get us away from a pivot front trailer like we have at the moment, which is that guy, the farm tech. And we could almost get the same price back for that as what the other one will cost us. But we can look at that another day, because that was not in the savings. Yep, sleep. Alright, so what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to plant in this month. We're coming into March, so we've got to decide what we want to put into this backfield. So what have we got? We've got this field over here. We need to determine what we want to put into there. And what I'm thinking... Oh, by the way, you might be able to notice we did come through with the fertilizer. So if we come up to here, jump back across, remove the mulched. Yeah, so we've got our first layer of fertilizer down. You'll notice that there's a section that needs rolling and a section that needs lime, apparently. But we can deal with that. We can spread that little bit of lime on before we plant, and we can take care of the needs rolling after it's planted. These guys, 100% fertilized, good to go. We've just got to let them continue to grow. But what we're going to do is get all of this flour up to the bakery, and it should take it all. I can't see why it wouldn't. And we're probably going the wrong way. But that's okay. We're out of winter, we're back into spring, so there's going to be things to do on our farm, and the main one is definitely going to be taking care of that field that needs planting. Spinnery drops. Bread there, waiting to be sold off. They can wait for a little bit longer. What we want to do is get all of this stuff. And it took it all. Perfect. So if we jump out and have a look, that should pretty much be as much flour as this place will take. Oh no. Okay, so it probably takes about close to 60,000. But what we can do is we can go up. Obviously, we got planks now storing, so we're going to need to move some of them over. I'll show you what we've done up there because we've cleaned it up a little bit. We've got our fabric. We should have 3 pallets up there, I think. What I want to do is put in the tailor shop. Down to 14,000, got 5,000 litres storing, so there's about 9,000 litres up there at the moment. Obviously we can fit 4 on the pad. The bread, like we've shown, we got 395 in there, but we do have 3 pallets. And then we've got our furniture. Nothing in here at the moment. The canola is currently growing, so we'll have canola oil to go in there. I'm thinking we might put some sunflowers in, get some more sunflower oil cranking. But I would like to start doing a root crop. So I'm thinking sugar beet. Because I'd love to put in a sugar factory at some point here as well. So what we'll do is we'll go and have a look at productions, namely the sawmill and the carpentry. So I want to get up and just quickly have a look and see what we need to do out there. We may actually potentially grab some pallets of stuff and get them sold off. And I've come the wrong way. It's alright, we'll just have to cut across. Oh, we've timed that perfectly. Get down here as the train's already gone through, so the gates open up for us. What we'll do is we'll have a look down here. I'll show you what I've done with the pallets and planks. Is getting pretty messy. As you can see, we've jumped them across, just tidied them up in front of the door there. So we'll do the same thing. Just get these tidied up. And we can sort of just move them in when we need them. But as you can tell, we've got a lot of timber sitting around here. So we're now 3 high, 2 deep. What is that? 5 wide. Pallets of furniture, we won't worry about touching them just yet. Pallet there of timber that's going to disappear in a second, so what we might actually do, just grab another one. just to keep them going. We'll jump up to the spinnery and we'll see what we've got up there in the way of fabric. Yep, it's all still sat there waiting. So we'll come around the side. Oh, those picnic tables are not a great spot. Obviously where the workers eat their lunch. So we've got three pallets of wool or fabric sitting there. And the next one is only halfway. So that'll be next month before we see that. So what I'm thinking, because we now have $158,000 in the account. Oh, we'll check this again for today. And nothing. They've just got rid of the good trailer and put a bad one there. So we don't want that. What we want to do is come into construction, into production, and we want the tailor shop. Now, I wonder if we can sort of put it up here somewhere. Would that make sense? I think it would. It is very uneven ground up here though. That's the only issue. So what we'll do is we'll bring that down to, where are we? This should be our field. Here we go. Where's our pallet spawn? At the back. Now, we're going to have a road come off in between them two. So if we give it a bit of space to be able to do the road, I reckon something like that's going to work perfectly for us. Okay, so we want to smooth that out. Sort of want to smooth it out coming off of here as well. Sort of want that road almost be at the same level. I don't want to go too hard here either. Right, so done that. Painting, asphalt. Change the shape. doesn't have to be pretty. We're going to fix it all up once we finish building the rest of our facilities up here. But that should work. And if we actually make that a bit bigger, and we have a walkway come down here. There we go. That'll do. So, what I reckon we do is pick up these three lots of fabric and we get that down to the tailor shop. What I would love to see as far as a mod come in would be truck or trailer that has the forklift that you can attach to the back of it, or I'm not sure if you see them in America or in Ireland, but the trailers, truck and trailers that we constantly see here in Australia with the small JCB, so I want like a one-ton JCB that we could put onto a low loader and move our pallets around with. We do have the Bobcat, but it's heavy. We may end up getting rid of that Bobcat, yet I'm not too sure. But we'll see you guys here in a second once we get down to the tailor shop. Quick screenshot. Right, let's get this stuff in. So, 3,000 litres of fabric. Our clothes, or tailor shop. Get that activated. So, we're only going to get 1,500 litres of clothes from that. That's all good. We've got a lot of wool sitting up at, a lot of cotton sitting up at the spinnery. So this will just be another one like the furniture. It's just going to produce over time, and every now and then we'll have a pallet to sell. The good thing is we'll get a pallet every month. So it's not as bad as the furniture, and it's not as bad as the fabric itself, although with it's probably on par. But anyway, we'll get that activated, get that underway, get that making some clothes for us. And what we need to do, we can probably put another entrance exit out of there. We'll get back down to the farm and we will put some seeds into the ground. Okay, so what we've got to determine is exactly what we want to put in. We did stop off at the servo on the way back, just beside the farm shop there, and put some more diesel in to the tractor. For those of you that aren't like Australian subscribers, when I say servo, I mean fuel station, gas station, petrol station. Right, so what I am thinking, to be honest, is these guys, sugar beet. we put sugar beet into here, that's right, I've got that little bit of lime to spread down. What we'll do, just quickly, leave that hooked up. What was I saying? Yeah, why I'm thinking sugar beets is because we do want to put the sugar mill in. Like I said, we're going to start focusing this series on productions. Now, we need the sugar mill in order to do chocolate and so forth. So we need that sugar mill on the go. Oh, there's nothing in it. Positive we had something in this. Okay. That's okay. Open him up, pull you underneath this guy. Don't need much. In fact, that's probably perfect. Have a look here, it literally is just that smallest section just here. Right, granted, there's a few little bits, not too concerned about that. Now, we could go and get the front piece for that planter, the fertilizer adder, but I don't really see the point. We are going to want to upgrade that planter sometime in the near future. Oh, so close. Just got this little bit on the edge here that we need to take care of. Not too worried about that little speck down in the bottom. That should have fixed it. There we go. We can get folded up, we can jump back in the fence, and we can start putting some sugar beet in the ground.
Oh, 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 oh
sort of hoping that we'd have enough left to get that last run done. But we don't buy about, say, 20 litres. Now, I don't want to put too much into this thing, so it's going to have to be quick. The reason is, I don't think we're going to be keeping this thing around for too much longer. Right. That should see us to the end. So, the less seeds we have in here, the better. Now, if we've only got, like, say, 10, 30 litres of seeds left, then we are definitely not going to worry about trying to get them out before we sell it. We'll just sell it with them in there. In fact, what we might do is whatever's left in there, we'll run up that outside edge where it didn't plant out. See how that works. But anyway, once we've got this done, we need to get a roller in here. We'll need to fertilize it as well. It does have one round of fertilizer in there. The next round we can wait until after the first, second growth stage. Doesn't really matter too much. But we definitely want to get that roller on here and get these seeds rolled into the ground. So it might actually pay to fertilize before we do that. That way it's rolling the fertilizer into the seed. What are we going to be left with here? 13 litres? 12 litres. Yeah. Wouldn't be worth taking out. So that was pretty good. Did pretty well there, I reckon. Let's see what happens if we run up here. Whether it will actually take any out. Not well. Not very quickly, but it will. So, probably left with 10 litres in here. Maybe 9. Obviously, we're going to have to concentrate on making a lot of money between now and harvest time. So we'll have harvest for... pretty sure the canola will come up first, or the soybeans, I'm not too sure. Oh, soybean, sugar beet, no. So yeah, it'll be canola harvest will come up start of July, and then our sugar beet harvest will come up in October. So we'll have the end of autumn to get the harvest done for the sugar beet. So by then we need to have enough money to A, rent the harvester. We're not going to be purchasing that. No way we're going to have that sort of money. We're going to have to find somewhere or somehow to store them. Even if we store them in the train elevator. Because we're going to have to put down the sugar mill as well. I don't think we're going to have enough money for that. Especially considering we've got 1, 2, 3 months or 3 in-game days before we need to get a harvester for the canola. We may be able to stretch it out to 4 if we don't harvest until August. Wrong way. we can either make that money with our productions, which is a possibility. I mean, we've got the bread, the furniture, and the clothes now. We may be able to do some fabric and sell off some fabric if we've got some sitting around. So we've got a few productions that make quite expensive materials. So we may be able to have the money we require, but the chances of that are slim, to say the least. So if we bring you back up again, and we bring you up, set that to auto with the make link 2. Just gonna go where that roller wants to go, so I have to readjust. Okay, let's get this underway. Oh, didn't quite go down as quick as I hoped. There we go. Actually, what we might do is turn it off. We will jump into here. So I've already got 160 litres of clothes in there. Not too bad. Furniture, we've got potentially another crate sitting up there. Bread's still getting on. We've got plenty of flour. We'll need to get the flour down to the bakery as well, or we could sell that off as well. And I don't think we're going to have another pallet up there. So what we'll do is we'll jump into the ute. And we'll go and have a look. What's going on with my frame rate here? Wow, why has that dropped down so bad? Okay, something's going on. It's not liking something in this area. Probably we've just got too much going on. Because so we'll let the worker go on with that. What we'll do is we'll finish off, we'll go and have a look around our productions, and we'll see if we can put a little bit more money back into the account before the end of the episode. shop now. As you can see, we've got a fairly decent load. It's not great, but it should be quite a decent bit of cash. So 5,500 litres of eggs. We could have made it over 6,000, but I figured the two pallets that were only slightly started may as well stay there. Three pallets of furniture and two pallets of bread. So 56,000. Let's see how we go. Not bad. Not bad at all. $38,000 back into the account. We won't let you go through that. It's too late now. So that almost brings us back up to 100 grand. So we went back to the farm. Let's see how the worker's doing. But he should actually be pretty close to getting finished with rolling. Rightio. So it almost got rolling done. We've just had to finish off the ends. We've got the other end tidied up. Now we've just got one more pass to do down here. We'll have that done as well. We are going to end the episode once we've got this rolled. Jump down. There we go. Yeah, we'll end the episode up here, so we've not done too bad. Quick recap, we've got our fabric pallets into the tailor shop so they can start making some clothes for us. Clothes, if I'm not mistaken, each pallet is like $25,000 or more, depending on what time you sell it at. We've got our sugar beet planted and rolled. We sold some bread, we sold some eggs, and we sold some furniture. Now, what I'm planning to do, really hoping to do, is not sell any more products until we get close to harvest. I don't want to spend any money, realistically, until we get close to harvest. If we have to, we have to. But at the end of the day, I need to make sure we have money in the account to rent the sugar beet harvester and potentially purchase, hopefully purchase, but potentially lease or rent the combine harvester at the same time for our canola. But anyway, guys, that's where we're going to leave it for today. One last quick check, nothing in there. So that's where we're going to leave it for today. Thanks for joining in. If you liked the video, please do not forget to hit that like. Also, don't forget to hit that notification bell or the subscribe button if you haven't already. And thanks for joining in, guys. We'll see you next time.